Welcome back to Health Bulletin. In today's video, we're discussing a critical question that's on everyone's mind. What's the difference in COVID-19 death rates between vaccinated and unvaccinated individuals? We'll be breaking down the latest data to give you a clearer picture of the pandemic's current landscape. Stay tuned as we unravel the numbers and what they mean for all of us. To understand how the pandemic is evolving, it's crucial to know how death rates from COVID-19 are affected by vaccination status, and what does it mean for us? The death rate is a key metric that can accurately show how effective vaccines are against severe forms of the disease. This may change over time when there are changes in the prevalence of COVID-19, and because of factors such as waning immunity, new strains of the virus, and the use of boosters. This video explains why it is essential to look at death rates by vaccination status, rather than the absolute number of deaths among vaccinated and unvaccinated people. We also visualize this mortality data for the United States, England, Switzerland, and Chile. We utilize data from Our World in Data, a platform that is entirely open source and publicly accessible. Be sure to check the description for the link. As a minimum, they listed country-specific sources where you can find similar data for other countries, and they describe how an ideal dataset would be formatted. But why do we need to compare the death rates between vaccinated and unvaccinated? During a pandemic, you might see headlines like, "Half of those who died from the virus were vaccinated." Based on such headline, it would be wrong to draw any conclusions about whether the vaccines are protecting people from the virus. The headline is not providing enough information to draw any conclusions. Let's explore this with the following example. Imagine we live in a place with a population of 60 people. The newspaper may read, "Half of those who died from the virus were vaccinated." But this headline does not tell us whether the vaccine protects people or not. To be able to say anything, we also need to know about those who did not die, and also how many people in this population were vaccinated, along with how many were not vaccinated. Now we have all the information we need and can calculate the death rates. Out of every 10 unvaccinated individuals, tragically, if half of them, that's 5 people, succumb to their illness, leading to an alarming death rate of 50% among those who hadn't received the vaccine. And so if out of 50 vaccinated people, 5 died, the death rate among the vaccinated is 10%. We therefore see that the death rate among the vaccinated is 5 times lower than among the unvaccinated. In the example, they created numbers solely to make the calculation of death rates easier, but the same logic also applies to the current COVID-19 situation. Comparisons of the absolute numbers, as some headlines do, mistake, known in statistics as a base rate fallacy. They completely ignores the fact that one group is much larger than the other. It is important to avoid this mistake, especially now, as in more and more countries, the number of people vaccinated against COVID-19 is much larger than the number of unvaccinated people. This example shows how to think about these statistics in a hypothetical case. Let's now examine the latest data surrounding the ongoing developments in the COVID-19 pandemic. We will specifically focus on COVID-19 mortality rates categorized by vaccination status. We're synthesizing official mortality data released by the United States, Switzerland, and Chile to give us a comprehensive view. In the United States, where the population has been primarily vaccinated with mRNA vaccines from Pfizer and Moderna, the CDC has released data showing COVID-19 death rates among 3 distinct groups: those who are unvaccinated, those vaccinated but without the latest bivalent booster, and those who have received the updated bivalent booster. The charts we have indicate that the weekly COVID-19 death rate for the unvaccinated remains the highest, while those with the updated bivalent booster show the lowest rate, suggesting a significant protective effect of the booster against mortality. Comparing the data from Switzerland and Chile reveals similar trends, with mortality rates consistently higher in unvaccinated populations. These visual representations underline the critical role that vaccination, and particularly booster doses, play in reducing the risk of death from COVID-19. Understanding these patterns is vital as we continue to navigate the pandemic, reinforce the importance of vaccination as a key tool in our public health arsenal. As we wrap up our discussion, it's crucial to emphasize that the data presented in these charts is current, As of August 2023, this information offers us a valuable snapshot of the pandemic's dynamics at this point in time. Understanding these trends is pivotal as we continue to navigate the complexities of COVID-19 and its impact on global health. Thanks for watching. Stay informed, stay safe. For more health updates and insights, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Until next time, take care and be well.